I'm finding Notion to be a great way to keep track of the guitar tabs you like to play, and thought I'd show you how I do that here. I don't play guitar much, but I play every now and then. It's nice to have, you know, the tabs and chords for the songs I like at my fingertips. There's great websites like Ultimate Guitar that I'll show you in a second that have lots of great ones to choose from, but I want to pick the, quote, best versions of each one, save them somewhere local, and just have the ones I want to play. So my personal collection has maybe 100 songs in it, something like that. But I'm going to show you how to do this pretty quickly with the Notion template. So here's this one here. I have this guitar tab. I have two songs in it so far. We'll go with Kenny Chesney today. So let's say we want to do another one of his. So we'll go over to Ultimate Guitar and find Don't Happen Twice. And again, some songs have multiple versions. This is where I like to find the version I like, maybe even tweak it a little bit. So we'll open it up and we'll look. And yep, this is good. I can handle these chords. It's not too bad. So we'll copy it. We'll take the text and copy it. So go in here, and obviously we'll hit a new line. We'll say, Don't Happen Twice. For the artist, you could make this a drop-down. You could make it a related database you want to tie in. I don't have enough to worry about that, so I just make it just text. I can always sort by that later, and it does it. The genre, you can do some drop-downs. So I have the single drop-down for country, but you could have different ones in there. You can do whatever you want in there. But then, of course, inside of each one, we want to paste the song. Now, the challenge here is if you just paste the song, it may show up like this, where it just puts it in normal font. You need a monospaced font for tabs to show up correctly and for it to keep the spacing. So you get issues like this where they don't line up at all, and then issues like this where it compresses every space like HTML does down to a single space, where really this A minor should be, you know, out here somewhere maybe. So instead what we'll do, I should delete this one. We'll go back again and add Don't Happen Twice. Kenny Chesney, and it's country. We'll open, and instead of just pasting it in, we'll do a code block, like an HTML block. It makes it look weird, but actually does it perfect, because now it's going to hold it, it's going to keep the spacing, keep things tight. Does a great job, and ultimately, that's all you need. Now you've got all your chords where you want them, you can pull up whatever song you want, it's all there, it's formatted nice, you can adjust what you want, does great. One other little trick, though, is a lot of songs, if you're playing along here, you know, you play a bit and then you got to kind of stop and scroll the screen a bit more. Most are just like two screens long. You could, if you fit them side by side, it kind of works. So if we go here and say probably starting at verse, maybe after verse two, probably about the chorus here, we'll take this chunk and cut it out. So we'll just Control X to cut. And then down here, we'll just do another code block and paste it in. And then we can just drag this, you know, every page in Notion, you can make column. We'll drag it and make a column on the side. Now it's looking pretty good. Little skinny, so we'll open as a page, still kind of skinny, but then in the upper right, we can click there and make it full width, and that works pretty well. If I scroll down and get it to the right place, at least on this screen, I can basically see the entire song without having to scroll, and it works well there, and of course, it's all just in with my templates. So if you're watching this like on YouTube, this template's available over at notiontips.com, but again, it's pretty easy to make your own if you want, and hope you find that helpful. Thanks.